Hello and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's tutorial, we will learn how to create sidebar navigation menu using only HTML and CSS. As you can see on my computer screen, I have this one background color. And also you can see I have this mobile screen. And on this mobile screen, you can see there's an image, background image. Also, we have this menu icon where if I click it, we can see our menu list. And on this menu, there's some beautiful hover effect. Also, we have this console feature. So we'll create this mobile nav using only HTML and CSS. So before starting this video, please hit the like button and also subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos. So without wasting time, let's start the video. Hello guys, welcome back again. So here I have one folder. Inside this folder, I have two files, one for my HTML and one for my CSS. Also, I have this one image. Now, let's open this folder with our VS Code. So, I'm using Visual Studio. Now, here is my index.html and I have written the basic HTML structure. You can see I have two doctype HTML. So, just first create one doctype. Then inside the doctype, create another doctype HTML, okay? Also, this is my style.css. For now, I have nothing. Now you can see I have connected my CSS file with HTML using this link tag. Also, I have this one title, mobile nav. And on my second HTML structure, I have this one title also, sidebar navigation. Also, I have this one link that is Google font. You can get your own URL fonts from Google Fonts. Now, come here under the body of our second HTML structure. Here we'll create one div with a class container. Inside this div, I'm going to create one more div with a class name phone. Again, we'll create one div with a class name content. Now inside this content, we're going to create some nav. So I'll say nav, and for this nav, I'm going to give it a role that is navigation. Inside this nav, we'll create one more div with an ID, menu toggle. Okay, so I'm going to add input. And the type is going to be checkbox. Now, after this, let's create just span tag. Simply copy this and paste it two more times. Now, next we need to create is our UL. So I'm going to create UL with an ID menu. Inside this UL, I'm going to create link list and anchor tag. And here I'm not going to give it any URL link, so I'll just leave it blank. And here is where I'm going to write my text form. Simply copy this . So let's change our text. That's all. Now you can see we have our menu list. Okay. And make sure you get this URL font. Now let's save this. And let's go back to our folder. Let's open this index.html with our browser. Now you can see we have our menu list. And we have our checkbox. Now come back to your VS Code. Let's go to the style. So here we're going to add some CSS styling to our HTML. First, I'm going to start with the body. And for my body, I'm going to give it a background color. Next, blood margin, padding, here I'm going to style all my anchor tags. So for my anchor tag, I'll give it text decoration to be none. Color, opacity, font family, next we'll add font size, font weight, I'll give it 400. Lastly, I'm going to add transition. Next, for my anchor tag, I'm going to add some hover effect. And here I'm going to give it opacity 0.5. Next, I'm going to style is my UL. Here I'm going to add padding 0. Also, I'm going to say list style type to be none. Next is my class container. For this class, I'm going to add margin top to be 50 pixel. Also, we need to add display to be flex, justify content, and align items. Next is my class phone. Here, I'm going to add background color. Border radius, width, height, also I'm going to say display to be flex. Next we need to add is justify content to be at the center. Also align items, center, and box shadow. And I'm going to add color. Next is my class content. Let me scroll up so that you can see clear what I'm doing here. So for my content, I'm going to add border, 1 pixel solid, next we'll add border radius, width, height, background, and here I'm going to add URL image dot. Okay, so this is the image that I'm adding here, and here I'm going to say background size, background repeat to be no repeat, and also we need to add background size to be cover. Next, I'm going to add overflow hidden. Now save this, save your file, go back to your browser, refresh it. Now you can see we have our mobile screen and also we have our menu list and our background image on our mobile screen. Also we have our checkbox. So next we need to style is our nav. So I'm going to say nav. And here I'm going to add two things, that is background color and height. Height, I'll give it 65 pixel. Next, I'm going to say my ID. So go back to your index.html, copy this ID. Here I'm going to say display to be flex. Flex direction to be column, position relative, top 25, left 25 also. Next, I'm going to add my Z index and I'll give it 1. Next, we'll add WebKit user select. Next, I'm going to add user select also to be none. Next, we're going to style is our input. And remember, we have given our input type to be checkbox. Okay, so here I'm going to say display to be flex, width to be 40 pixel. Height 32 pixel. Also, we are going to add position to be absolute, cursor pointer, and opacity we are going to give it 0. Lastly, we are going to add Z index to be 1, or let's give it 2. Now save your file, go back to your web browser, refresh it. Now you can see we can see our checkbox. So come back to your text editor. Here I'm going to say again my span tag. Remember, I created 3 spans here, 3 span tag. So for our span tag, I'm going to give it display to be flex. Also, I'm going to add width of 29 pixel. Height 2 pixel, position to be relative. Also, I'm going to add background, and here I'm going to add color code. Next, we'll add border radius of 3 pixel, Z index, transform origin. And here I'm going to give it 5 pixel by 0 pixel. Next, I'm going to add transition. And I'm going to say transform 0.5 second. Cubic. And I'm going to use this cubic bezier. And here I'm going to give it 0.77, 0.2. Also, I'm going to add 0.05 and 1. Next, we need to add is background. Sorry, just remove this. So here, I'm going to add background 0.5 second. And here I'm going, all I'm just copy the whole of this. Okay. And we are going to add few things. So after this, I'm going to add opacity. Let me just do this. Opacity. And for my opacity, I'll give it 0.55. 0.55 second is. Next is, next I'm going to add first child to our span tag. And here I'm going to say transform origin 0%, 0%. Now I'll save this, reload our web page. Now you can see we have our menu icon is coming up. Okay, so next I'm going to say, let me just copy this. So that's an ID, okay? So here I'm going to say span, and I'm going to use the nth child, okay? No, let's use the nth last child first, okay? The nth last child, and I'm going to give it to open your curly braces, and here we're going to add transform origin again, and I'm going to say 0% by 100%. Next is our input, and I'm going to say checked. Also, I'm going to add my span tag, and here I'm going to give it opacity to be 1. Also, I'm going to say transform rotate 45, and also I'm going to say translate negative 3 pixel by negative 1 pixel. Okay, background. Next, I'm going to say still our menu input. So just copy this. Just remove that. So here I'm going to say nth child. We're going to add opacity 0. Also, we'll add transform rotate. Or let's just give it 0 for now, okay? Also, I'm going to add a scale here. And for my scale, I'll give it 0.2. 0.2. Okay, so next what we need to do is I'm going to make a few changes. So for this one, I'm going to say nth last child, okay? Next is, again, copy the whole of this. I'll give it a value by the 3. So just remove this. Just copy the whole of this again. And here I'm going to say, again, we're not going to change anything, but we're going to change our value of nth last child, and I'm going to give it 2. And let's remove this opacity, we don't need it. And here I'm going to change my rotation. So I'm going to give it negative 45. Also, I'm going to give it 0 for our scale. Or let's just remove the scale, we don't need it. So here I'm going to say translate, and I'm going to give 0, comma, negative 1 pixel. That's all. Now finally, we are going to edit is our menu. For my menu, I'm going to give it position to be absolute. Also, I'm going to add width, height, let's change our width to be 180. Next, I'm going to add box shadow, 10 pixel. Also, I'm going to add color code. Next, I'm going to say margin. For my margin, I'm going to give it negative 50 pixel 0, 0, negative 50 pixel. Okay. Next padding to be 50 pixel. Padding top. Background color. Let's just change our background color here. So here I'm going to give it okay. Again, I'm going to use WebKit font smoothing, okay. Next, what we need to add is transform origin. Again, I'm going to add transform, translate. So here I'm going to give it negative 100%, zero. Lastly, I'm going to say transition. Transform. So if you go back, let's just copy the whole of this. So paste it here. Okay. So next is just again, we're going to style our menu list, okay? And here I'm going to give it padding 10 pixel by 0. Also, we're going to add transition delay to be 2 seconds. Lastly, I'm going to say menu. Input checked, and here we're going to add UL for our UL, and I'm going to say transform to be none. Now save this, and also make sure you have connected your CSS with HTML using this link tag. Okay, now go back to your web browser, refresh it. You can see still we have our problem with our menu icon, but you can see our menu list is okay. So go back to your text editor. So guys, now if you come back to our text editor, just don't first check your if your HTML is all correct, and second we need to check is our style.css. Now can see if you go back to our web browser again, we can see our menu icon and also our cancel icon. Okay, so for this, the problem is maybe we have to do with a margin bottom or margin top. Okay, now let's just see our menu where we created menu. See here you can see the problem is here. So after the height, we need to add just add margin bottom, okay, not margin top. Use margin bottom, and here I'm going to give it maybe let's say 5 pixel, which is okay. Now let's save this file and see if we corrected our mistake. Now come back to your web browser, refresh. Now you can see our menu icon. Let's try to click it. That's nice. Now you can see we have our cancel feature. Let me just zoom out. Now guys, you can see we have completed creating our mobile nav. And if we click this menu icon, you can see we have our sidebar navigation. And also you can see on this sidebar navigation menu, there's some beautiful hover effect. Also, we can cancel. So guys, we have completed this tutorial. So if you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button and also subscribe to my YouTube channel. And also, if you are new to my channel, please kindly subscribe and also share. So till next time.